Hello everyone, thank you for tuning in. Today's question is why this car is so popular. Well, actually it has a few reasons, but let's first get the car out of the box and I choose this shining pink color. In the box we of course we have the remote controller and we have two level speed and throttle rate and trimming button. Remote controller feels really nice. I don't know what kind of plastic they have used, but when you touch it, it feels so soft. You know, it is cheap, but it doesn't feel cheap. That's nice. The user manual. So they also sent some accessories, but you need to install them on yourself and loads of stickers, USB charger. And I got the two batteries version, 500 milliamps, 7.4 volts lithium ion battery here. And of course, the car itself. Look at this. It really looks cool. Okay, why this car has high sale rates? So the first reason, Japan. You know, this is the model car of 1979 Suzuki Carry, and this is the part of Japan's growing history. After the Hiroshima in 1945, Japan start growing again, and when they come to 1960s, that growing requires more effective logistics. So that car should be, logistics actually, should be cheap and practical. And Suzuki in 1961 came out with Suzuki Carry, with the first generation. And this one is the seventh generation, which has been start manufactured at 1979 until 1985. It was cheap, it was practical, it was actually powerful. It just have, I think, 0.67 or 0.7 cc engine in it, and it gives up 60 horsepower, if I'm not mistaken. So that's why Japanese people are buying this car, because this is a part of their history. On the other hand, why we are buying this? First of all, this is a classic looking, awesome car. And for example, you can use this car as a drift car, a real wheel drive drift car. Actually, just buying a 12 millimeter hex adapter, or they are already on the market, a special drift tires for this car. And if you buy those drift tires for $10, I think, you would have the cheapest rear-wheel drive drift car. Some people are, you know, adding some more professional axles and use this as a crawler also. But the best way, in my opinion, to use this car as a drift vehicle. So, as I told you, this is a rear-wheel drive car. All drivetrain are made out of plastic, but there are tons of upgrade parts of this car already on Banggood or any other online retailers. I'm also going to put the link of the upgrade parts of this car into the description. Here, our battery compartment. You need to turn the wheel and the compartment opens. Let me just plug in the battery. And actually, you don't need too much place here. I mean, you cannot use bigger batteries in this side of the car, so you can modify and, you know, put your battery if you would like to use a 2S LiPo battery maybe into trunk. It's a little bit frustrating to putting the battery inside the battery compartment. No, finally, when you turn on the car, actually first we should turn on the remote control, but I would like to turn on the car first because I would like to show you something. So, if you turn on the car without transmitters turned on, sorry, the remote controller turned on, the lights are flashing and warns you that your remote controller is off. And when you turn on your remote controller, see? Now the lights are stable. So I would like to show you the throttle and the steering rates. Each time you turn on the car, the throttle and the string level, the default is low. So I mean, look at this. This is low string, and when you press the string button here just once, you get more string. And I think they already knew that people are going to use this as a drift car, because when you are going to use this car as a drift car, you need more steering. Also for the throttle, low throttle, which is sounds good, right? And high speed. See? It has a 370 brush motor on it, but quite fast actually. Of course, you can also upgrade this to the brushless system, but before upgrading the car to the brushless, you need to upgrade the axles, drivetrains, or other parts to the, you know, metal ones, because I don't think this drivetrain could handle the brushless motor for a long time. But even this speed, it's okay to use this as a drift car with proper drift tires. And do we have proportional throttle? We know we already have proportional steering, but can we use the throttle proportional? Yes, we can. And the car is at the moment using the high speed level. So let me make it low again. Try like this. Yes. So as I am going to use this as a drift car, when I get my orders, I already ordered the hex adapters and also the gyro. This could be the cheapest 1/10 scale rear wheel drive drift car. I already have 4 drift cars, but I don't have a rear wheel drive drift car, which is actually the most important way to drift the RC car, you know, because 4x4 drift cars are a little bit easy to use, but I have been thinking to get one rear wheel drive one. So when this car came out, I thought this is a cool looking car and I can use this as a rear wheel drive drift car. And again, this is one of the best budget cars in 1/10 scale. It has a history, it has cool looking, you can use this as a crawler, you can use this just with the stock setup, or you can use this as a drift car like most of the people are using who purchased this car already. If you would like to buy this car, you can find the link in the description. You can find the upgrade parts links in the description. And as always, thank you for watching. Have a good day.
need to introduce myself. I'm a name of wealth and taste.
I'm a king of rap, there is none higher. Sucker MCs to call me sire. To burn my kingdom, you must use fire. I won't stop rocking till I retire.
Now we rock the party.